So, present session or today's session is on creativity and innovation. You are all aware of creativity and you are all creative persons and also innovative. The contents which we are going to cover during this session is, or they are like this. Number one, creativity and types of innovation, conceptual blocks. There may be three conceptual blocks: constancy, compression, and complacency. Third is three components of creativity we will be discussing. Fourth, the paradoxical characteristics of creative groups. Fifth, tools for defining problems and creating new ideas. Sixth and the final point is developing a creative climate or climatic culture as such, creative culture which you call. So, that is to be created and that is the management responsibility. Beside these points, we will be covering some exercises which we will be doing in between and that will also be part of the session, so that we can interact on creativity and innovation. So, we start with creativity and types of innovation. What is creativity? Creativity is bringing into existence a new idea that is new or an idea that is new. Idea has to be new for you as well as for the general public, to your colleagues and your students, everyone, that this is a new idea. And what is innovation, or what is the difference between creativity and innovation? Innovation is the practical application of creative ideas. So, one is thinking new and second is applying that new idea which you have thought of and public has accepted it, or you yourself have accepted it and you want to go for its application, like registering a patent on your name, applying for patent or producing some product on that basis or render some service on that basis. And third component may be creative thinking. What is creative thinking? It is an innate talent that you were born with and a set of skills that can be learned, developed and utilized in daily problem solving. That is, this is a process of thinking, that you are thinking new, how you think and how you utilize those ideas which you think. That is also part of creativity, because your thinking has to be creative. Creative solutions are more than ideas. They must work in the real world. The attributes of creativity or creative thinking are: it should be new, it should be useful, in that it solves the problem or solves some problems. It is feasible given the messy real world, that is, it is viable or it can be done, it can be put to practice or put to application. These are the three features of creativity or creative solutions, creative thinking. Now, types of innovation. Innovation can be business model innovation, it may be process innovation, it may be product innovation, it may be service innovation. Business model innovation, that some people do business differently in a different creative way, different model they adopt. and the process innovation is there may be change, like you teach in the college, you make some innovative changes in that, you go by case history of different engineers and managers and there how they succeeded. You give the examples of those or their case histories, you discuss some case studies in the class rather than a general chalk and talk lecture. Product innovation and service innovations. Another point which is to be remembered in creativity and innovation, if you want to be creative and just make your students creative and innovative, you have to not to believe on the experts, what experts say, because some examples of the experts are given here. Don't believe the experts. Why? There are some quotations of the experts given here. That is an amazing invention, but who would ever want to use one of them? Said US President Rutherford B. Hayes after participating in a trial telephone conversation between Washington and Philadelphia in 1876. So, when he participated in a telephonic conversation, he said he will be going to use these telephones. What you can see, that telephone is number one used thing these days. Everybody keeps on talking, even if you are keeping a hand on your ear, people think that he or she is talking on telephone, we should not disturb. Another quotation of the expert is, television would not be able to hold on to any market it captures. After the first 6 months, people will soon get tired of staring into a box every night. This is said by Daryl F. Zemeck, head of 20th Century Fox, 1946. This is the company president said, and he said that these television will not be a successful venture as such, and nobody will keep on staring at a box. But you can see the plight of televisions, it is a very successful media. Another quotation here is given by another expert, the horse is here to stay. What the automobile is only a novelty, it is a fad. This is just like a fashion or fad, it will end. This is what is said by President Michigan's Savings Bank 1903, advising Henry Ford's lawyer not to invest in the Ford Motor Company. Disregarding the advice, he invested $5,000 in the stocks, which he sold several years later for $12.5 million. So that also proved wrong, that some experts said something and automobile will fail and this company will not succeed, don't invest in its stocks. For Ford Motor Company became very successful venture. Ford Motors is one of the big three of the USA in automobiles, that is General Motors, Ford Motors and Chrysler Corporation. Third or the next quotation on this is, I think there is a worldwide market for about 5 computers. This is said by Thomas J. Watson, senior chairman of IBM in 1943. So, he said ki not more than 5 computers people will be able to sell, but you can see the plight of computers or the present state of affairs with the computer. Everybody is busy working on computers, nobody looks after the people. Even if you are going to someone's office, he will be busy with the computer for some time, only then he will see and look to you or talk to you. He will say that, give me 5-10 minutes, I will just send an email and thereafter I will talk to you. So, this is what experts or many experts say something with a lot of conformity, but they lot of confidence, but that doesn't hold true in the long run. So don't believe in experts if you are to become creative person or make your students creative, or you are to create a climate of creativity in your colleges. What are the conceptual blocks to creativity? These are some of the blocks we are going to discuss, and their block busters to enhance the creativity. Making assumption is a block. You assume something and then you do or don't do it, or do according a patterned way. But checking assumptions after making assumption is important, because that can be a block buster, that can bust that block, and that can lead you to success, because you checked it and you deleted some of the assumptions or many assumptions you made to do something. You said these assumptions are not true, and only these one, two assumptions are there which we will be retaining, rest of the things will be not considered during the process. Another block is following the rules. Like you follow the, keep on following the rules, you become a conformist and you don't think beyond the box. Again, box thinking comes to you, like library rules. If you don't break those, you don't read the books carefully. Because for reading books, you need some time, and that is also leisure time. Unless your mind speaks that you read this book thoroughly well, you don't read it. It may be lying before you or under your pillow, you don't read it. Unless the mind says that I should read it. So, you cannot return the books as per the rules of the library. So, if you break the library rules, perhaps you are the creative person, you may be entrepreneurs, because entrepreneurs are non-conformists. They will not conform to the rules. They will break the rules. When you break the rules, you become blockbusters. Yeah, students also, some of the students or most of the students will be breaking rules. Only a few who are your very follower type, they may be gold medalist and number 1, 2, 3 or 5 ranks, they will not break the rules. Some of them also break the rules, but they will be breaking it intelligently without telling you that we are breaking it. But the rest of the class will be breaking the rules. Mediocres will break the rules, and they are the entrepreneurs, they are the creative people. Yeah, sometime you have to break the rules if you are to become creative. So that is what is said, and blockbuster is break the rules. Over reliance on logic is the third block, and blockbuster is use imagination and intuition instead of logic. All the time logic should not hold true, or will not hold true for becoming a creative person. You have to go beyond the logic, that is, you have to go for divergent thinking, lateral thinking. Otherwise, you are on convergent thinking, vertical thinking. You have to go for the lateral thinking, as Edward Bono has said in his book, best-selling book, Lateral Thinking. Fourth block is fear of failure, and the blockbuster for this is risk-taking culture. Unless you take risk, you will keep on fearing from the failure. I may fail, I will not invest in this stock or in the stock market, and it may just burst any time, so I should not invest. But some people will go and burn their fingers, and they are the real earners also. Sometimes they lose also, but risk taking is part of the game for becoming creative or becoming entrepreneur. So, conceptual blocks we have already explained. These are the mental obstacles in the way of problem solving. Conceptual blocks, some examples are more formal education individuals have, or more experience they have on the jobs, the less able they are to solve the problems in the creative ways. More education and more experience will make you less creative. Kehte hain na, in nanne nanne haathon ko chand sitare chhu lene do, चार किताब में पढ़ लेंगे तो हमारे जैसे हो जाएंगे. सो डोंट स्टॉप योर चिल्ड्रन फ्रॉम डूइंग समथिंग, स्क्रिबलिंग समथिंग ऑन द नोटबुक एंड वेस्टिंग सम पेजेस. लेट देम वेस्ट इट. इवन राइटिंग ऑन द वॉल्स इज अ लोड फॉर द चिल्ड्रन. दे शुड राइट इट एंड यू शुड से दैट यस व्हाट यू हैव मेड. एंड यू कैन से दैट यस सम पेंटिंग इज इमर्जिंग आउट ऑफ दिस. यू आर डूइंग समथिंग वंडरफुल. So you have to appreciate their skills because you are developing the skills. You cannot, if he is playing with the knife, let him play for some time, but tell that this can tear off your finger also, blood will come out. So be careful, but let him do something with that. He might be using it in a creative way for something. Or cutting some your newspapers or waste papers, and then you say that no, I have to sell it in Raddi, don't waste these papers because I will earn some money out of it, and you are just tearing them off and making me lose the Raddi. Another thing is formal education often produce right answers, analytical rules or thinking boundaries. And similarly, experience on the job teaches us proper ways of doing things, specialized knowledge and rigid expectations of appropriate action. They'll tell you the logic and some numbers or some proper ways, systematic ways of doing the things. But for becoming creative, you have to deviate from that, do things divergently in a different way. Individuals lose the ability to experiment, improvise and take mental detours. If they are logical, if they are more educated and more experienced, they will keep on advising children also, don't do this way because I did it, I lost this much and others did it, so they lost it, and don't do it because this is what I am a qualified person telling you these things. So actually he is not qualified for becoming you making yourself or your children creative because you are not intelligent for that. Let them do it and appreciate what they are doing, and they might be doing something wonderful. Types of conceptual blocks may be constancy. What is constancy? It is vertical thinking or one thinking language. You think in one language only, or you think vertical thinking, you don't think literally. So that is constancy. That is again looking into the box, seeing the TV daily and not seeing beyond that, never listening to radio or never listening to your music CDs, sometimes switching off TV at home and or spoil it, and then keep on just listening to radio or some music for some time. That will make you creative because you are beyond constancy, otherwise you are a constant person. Compression will also lead to creativity because it will help you distinguishing figures from the space or figures from the ground. It will create some artificial constraints and that will lead you to creativity. Another thing may be complacency. When you are complacent, then it may become a block, but when you become inquisitive, your inquiry power increases. Otherwise, you become non-inquisitive and non-thinking, and hence this complacency will take you to a satisfactory sort of affairs. As we go to the temple or Gurdwara and say, Bhagwan ji, we are happy, and whatsoever you have done, you have given enough to us, please keep on giving this much. I am satisfied with life, I don't need anything but peace and stability. But you are to ask something more beyond that, you know. That no, I want to be a wonderful person, I want to be a creative person, I want to be an entrepreneur, and I need more and more. So only then you will be creative, otherwise you are satisfied person, you will be complacent, and that will reduce your inquiriness and thinking power. You will stop thinking much. Three components of creativity are expertise, motivation, creative thinking skills. So, expertise, you know, this is the knowledge as you acquire more and more knowledge and try to apply those knowledge principles, you become more creative. Motivation, when you keep on motivating yourself first and then motivating others, daily motivating some people, yes, you can do, you just keep it up. You are intelligent person, do it, you can do it. So, don't get frustrated. Keep on telling to your children, to your parents, to your younger brothers, sisters and your students, then they feel motivated that you are the person positive and motivating, and they will get a positive kick from that. So, positive talk has to be there for motivating people, and creative thinking skills are to be developed. The paradoxical characteristics of creative groups, beginner's mind versus experience. So, who is more creative is beginner will be more creative, because otherwise you keep on teaching, you will become more patterned and systematic, and thereafter will not think beyond that. Freedom is more creative than the discipline. Play will be more creative, make a person more creative than the professionalism. Improvisation will be more creative than the planning habit, that is, you plan and write all the steps rather than improvisation on each of the steps, or you may write, just don't plan it in the beginning and keep on going like that only, and then you plan it on the way. So, you will be more creative. There are some myths about creativity, some falsehoods or some wrong beliefs as such. Number one is, smarter you are, the more creative you are. So, this is also a myth, this is a false thing, as a false statement, that smarter you are, the more creative you are. It is not true. Even the person who is passive, he can be more creative. The young are more creative than the old. This is also untrue. Creativity is reserved for the few, the flamboyant risk takers. This is untrue. Creativity is solitary act. So, it is not that you are always a solo person and you can be creative. It is in groups also creativity can happen. You cannot manage creativity. So, this is also wrong. Creativity can be managed. Tools for defining problems. When you are to make a creative atmosphere, you search for some tools. And tools for defining problems, there are three different tools. One is Kipling method, second is problem statement, third is challenge method. Kipling method is Rudyard Kipling. You might have heard of a person. He said, there are 5 W's and 1 H, who are my servants. I keep on tying to my bed, you know, and whensoever I am facing a problem, I ask these 7 servants, 5 W's and 1 H, that why, what, when, where, who and how. So, all these will be answering all my problems or all my questions which I have in mind. Whensoever I face problems, I use the services of these five W's and 1 H as servants. Other tool is problem statement. You might have heard of, for research also, when you start research, the guide or the supervisor whom you choose as guide, he says, first you define your problem. Define, give a statement to your problem. What is your problem? What you want to do, and only then I can guide you. So, problem once defined, half of the research work is over. problem once stated, half of the research work you have already done means clarity of the objective comes to your mind. Third is challenge method, that is you challenge the person or challenge yourself and you become creative, because you put yourself in problems or others, you put others into problem when you say something with a lot of force on that. People may become creative or give some assignments which are not there in the books, make them tense and they become creative. Tools for creating new ideas are three. These tools are attribute listing, brainstorming and visioning. Attribute listing is the morphological analysis which we carry out of particular idea, new idea. Like you are to make a screwdriver, how you will make it? There will be handle, there will be fork, there will be torque in that, or there will be some portion which can hold the screw, and then you can have a handle. How big handle you want to have on the screwdriver? So that attributes. What will be the things? If you want to make a vehicle, you want that four tires will be there, or two tires will be there, three tires will be there to balance it, and there will be body, there will be handle, there will be engine. So that is the morphological analysis or attribute listing you do, and then analyze those. Brainstorming is another tool as such. You ask people to come together, sit together and keep on giving ideas. Quantity is dominating the quality in those ideas, because you don't criticize the ideas, no idea will be criticized, and quantity will be encouraged, and you make people creative because their ideas will be grouped and then a solution will be worked out of that. Visioning or the vision, tunnel vision first and then the diversified vision. And when you have a vision, longer the vision, better creative or more creative you will be. Developing a creative culture, you can do these things which are listed here. Risk taking is acceptable to management. When it is acceptable really in your situations, then you are creative. Employees have access to knowledge sources. When they have access to the knowledge sources, library, etc., they will be more creative. Innovators are rewarded. When this culture prevails, then naturally when people who do good work will be rewarded, then a creative culture exists or can be created. New ideas and new ways of doing things are welcomed. Information is free flowing. So, information, no dearth of information, you can get the information for becoming creative in your organization, then you will be really creative, like internet, etc., telephone, etc. Good ideas are supported by the executive patterns, so that will also make you creative. Developing a creative climate, what you can do for creating a climate, this is gist of the previous things only, summary of that only, that is you are to make people motivated, give them challenge and have them lot of fun in the organization. It should not become a drudgery, you know, your teaching should not be a drudgery, it should be a fun, learning is a fun, and you should of course keep on giving them challenges. Empowerment, when you empower people, let them do themselves, then they do it better, otherwise you keep on lecturing them and then they will not learn much, because that will lead to freedom, time and support to them will be given, and hence they will do better things. Dynamism is another thing which you should just put into your culture in your college. It will inbreed energy amongst the people, and debate and dialogue between the people will also lead to dynamism and make them creative. Openness is another characteristic, that is experimentation, trust and risk has to be just embedded into the system, so that they become more free and more experimenting type of people. You trust them, even if they fail, you don't say them much, and risk taking becomes a habit of those people. So, this is a puzzle. I think after this afternoon session you are feeling a bit bored, you know, because it is lot of stomach is filled. So, our energy go for digesting of the food and hence we feel sleepy. This is very tough session as such in the afternoon, and some people may feel sleepy, you know. So, this is a puzzle. There are 9 points. I put these points here also. 9 points which are at equal distance. 9 points in this also, 9 points they are put at equal distance. You are to join these 9 points by 4 straight lines without lifting your pen. Once you start it, you will not lift the pen, but only 4 lines should be there joining all the 9 points. So, this is given. Draw 9 points on the blackboard as shown below. Join the 9 points by 4 straight lines without lifting your pen once you start. So, this is a creative problem. You did it. So, can you demonstrate it on the board? Who else did it? So, give 3 hands to them, ovation, and just you come and demonstrate it. This is how this can be done. Mila diye inhone, but pattern of drawing is bit not that which is acceptable one. But he has done this, like figure will emerge. First you join 3 points in the straight line horizontal, you go horizontally first, then you come down vertically joining other 2 points, then you go diagonally. And then coming again diagonally, or first horizontally, then diagonally 2 points, then vertically, and then diagonally again. So, that is what the solution is. There are some 10 creative thinking quizzes here. See a mosquito and bit of blood on your ceiling, and you are to interpret that. Whose blood? You may say that this is mosquito's blood, but it will be bit of yours because mosquito has taken your blood, and bit of mosquito, bit of your blood. Puzzle 2. There is a flash of light and a man dies. The man is not killed by any other person and he does not die of any illness like a heart attack, etc. It is not a case of suicide either. Can you suggest a logical explanation? They are not related. The man is a lion tamer posing for a photo with his lion. The lion reacts badly to the flash of the camera, and the man cannot see properly, so he gets mauled. So, we forego these.